Hello everyone, my name is Nidhi Chauhan. I am assistant professor in Suresh Gandhi School of Pharmacy. And today we will discuss about this alkyl halide. In our last lecture, we have discussed about alkyl halide also, where we have discussed the chemical reaction and the method of preparation. So today, this topic, alkyl halides, that you all know that it comes in your pharmaceutical organic chemistry first in your second semester. So today here we are, a learning objective of this topic is, here we are going to study about the rearrangement of carbocations, and also we are going to study about the structures and uses of organic compounds that are related to this alkyl halides. And next, the student outcome. So here the students are going to know about the hydride shifts, the alkyl shifts in carbocation. So what are the hydride shift and what are the alkyl shifts that we are doing in the to achieve the stability in the tertiary, primary, secondary and tertiary carbocations. So which one is the most stable carbocation? And also they are going to learn about the structure and uses of your ethyl chloride, tetrachloroethylene, or your iodoform. So their structure, their uses, and their structure uses, their properties, where they are used in in the medical or in the cosmetic industry, or where they are used. So here, these are the learning objectives and the student outcomes of this topic, alkyl halide. Next, the first topic is your rearrangement of carbocations. So here in this, the name signifies that the rearrangement, there is an arrangement of the carbo, there is an arrangement, rearrangement in this carbocation. So here the carbocation rearrangement are defined as the movement of a carbocation from an unstable state to a more stable state through the use of various structural reorganizational shifts within the molecule. So here, carbocation rearrangement. Carbocation means the carbon that is containing the positive charge on it, where there is a deficiency of electron. That carbon, so that is why it is having the positive charge on it. And the rearrangement means there is a rearrangement in this carbocation. So it is defined as the movement. So here the movement of carbocation from an unstable state. Firstly, it is an unstable state, and we are moving it from the unstable state to the more stable state. Through we are doing various structural reorganizational shifts. We are doing many shifts in this carbocation, and we are moving this carbocation from an unstable state to a more stable state, and this all is happening in within the molecule. So this is your carbocation rearrangement. So whenever an alkyl halide, alcohol or alkene, is transformed into a carbocation, the carbocation rearrangement is formed. So when there is a alkyl halide in your alkyl halide or in your alcohol or in your alkene, when these are transformed into your carbocation, then there is a carbocation rearrangement is formed. When this alkyl halide, alcohol or alkene, when they are in the unstable state, and we have to move these unstable state of this carbocation to a more stable state, then this carbocation rearrangement is done, is formed. There are two types of carbocation rearrangement. So here we are going to discuss about there two type of carbocation rearrangements, and that is our a hydride shift and an alkyl shift. So here the hydride shift is here you can see in this example that whenever a nucleophile attacks a molecule, there is a formation of two products. Okay, whenever there is a nucleophile that attacks to your reactant or your molecule, then there is a formation of two products, that products that are your major product and your minor product. So in most of the cases, there is a formation of your major product, that is your rearranged product that we have rearranged it, and that is more substituted also. That is more substituted and that is more stable also. So here, when a nucleophile attacks to your reactant or your molecule, there is a formation of these two products. And in most of the cases, there is a formation of this major product this major product is your rearranged product and is more substituted, as well as it is more stable also. And the minor product is less substituted. And this minor product is less substituted and less stable. So here, between these two products, the one product is your major product, which is your more stable and more substituted, and your minor product, which is less stable and is less substituted also. The formed carbocation then undergo a rearrangement called a hybrid shift. So here, if the carbocation formed, we have to arrange there. We have to rearrange it. We have to rearrange it, and that is known as your hydride shift. Then that rearrangement is known as your hydride shift. So this means that the hydrogen is moved from one carbon to the neighboring carbon atom. So here, this hydride shift means that here you will see that the hydrogen is moved from the one carbon atom to the neighboring, that is your less substituted carbon atom. So here in this hydride shift, in this example, you will see here, this is your alcohol, okay? So here you will see that CCH3, the C is substituted, the CH3, then one H is attached to it, then this is your carbon, and this carbon is attached to one OH, and this is your CH3 and your H. So when this is reacted with this HCl in the presence of 0 degree centigrade, then there is a formation of these two, three products. Firstly, this minor product is formed. Secondly, this major product is formed. And a water molecule is also removed out from here. So in this minor product, you will see that the carbon is present. This chlorine is present on the less substituted carbon. And this chlorine is present on the more substituted carbon. Okay, here you will see that this carbon, this chlorine is attached where only one alkyl group is present. And here you will see that this chlorine is attached to the carbon atom where two alkyl groups are present. Okay, so again, here the hydride shift is will occur. And again, rearrangement of carbocation means, or you can say the carbocation rearrangement means that there is a movement of the carbocation from an unstable state to a more stable state through the use of your various structural reorganizational shift, which is happening within the molecule. And whenever there is an alkyl halide, alcohol, or your alkene, in that case, there is a transformation into this carbocation, and this carbocation rearrangement is done. So we are going to study about the two type of carbocation rearrangement. So first one is your hydride shift, and the secondly, it will be your alkyl shift. So in your hydride shift, then whenever there will be an attack by a nucleophile on the molecule or the reactant, there is a formation of a two product. There you will get the two product, and the one product will be your major, and the secondary product will be your minor. So here there is a formation of a major product, that is a rearranged product, and that is more substituted, and the minor product is less substituted, and it is also less stable. So here the formed carbocation will undergo a rearrangement, and that is known as your hydride shift. It means there is a hydrogen moves from one neighboring carbon atom to the another neighboring carbon atom from a more substituted, one hydrogen will move from one carbon to the less substituted carbon atom. So in this reaction, you will see that this alcohol, when reacting with this HCl, so there is a formation of these three products. One is your major, second is your minor, and the third is your water molecule. So here in this case, you will see the four steps are there. The alcohol portion OH has been substituted with the chlorine atom. However, this is not a direct substitution of the OH. So here you will see this. See this. In this first step, you will see the protonation. This HCl, in this HCl, there is a dissociation. This H will get the positive charge and this Cl will get the negative charge. So this H will attack to this O because there is a presence of the lone pair as well as it is an electronegative carbon atom. So here you will see this is formed. This product is formed. And after that, on the second step, you will see this water molecule. Here you will see there is a formation of this water molecule, H2O. So from here, this H2O will remove out. So here you will see loss of water. In the second step, you will see there is a loss of water molecule from here. And this carbon will withdraw electron because it is having the positive charge and it is also electronegative. That is why it will withdraw electron. So it will withdraw electron from here, from this carbon atom, and this carbon will get the positive charge. So here it is happening a hydrolysis and it is not homolysis. Homolysis means properly substituted. Means both will get the same number of electrons. But here, this is getting a negative charge and this carbon is getting the positive charge. So this will withdraw electron from here and there is a process of hydrolysis through hydrolysis process. And this carbon will get the positive charge and this H2O, from here, this O valency will be fulfilled and the water molecule will remove out from here. You can see here. So here you will see that this carbon will get the positive charge on it. This carbon is having the positive charge. So here, the carbon get the positive. So here, this is the formation of this carbocation. So this is your carbocation because the carbon is having the positive charge on it. Now, in the third step, you will see hydride shift is happening because this carbon, which is a carbocation formed, is a less substituted carbon. And you will see here, it is having one CH3. It is your secondary because here you will see one this side and one this side. This is your secondary. And secondary is less stable compared to the tertiary. So we have to make a stable carbocations. That is why we are shifting this hydrogen from here. And why it is known as hydride? Because here the hydrogen will withdraw electron from this carbon atom. In many cases, we have seen that the hydrogen leaves its electron on the other atom and it does not withdraw electron. Here you will see this is known as proton. So here protonation occur because here this H is having less electron. It is having no electron. It is having the positive charge. That is why it is known as proton. And here it is known as hydride because it withdraw electron from this carbon atom and it is having the negative charge on it. So this negative charge hydrogen will then attack to this neighboring carbon atom. So here you will see the rearrangement of carbocation is done from here to here. So here this hydrogen is rearranged to this carbon atom and this carbon will get the positive charge. Now it is the this carbon atom is more stable carbocation than this carbon atom. As you can see here, three alkyl shifts are there. Three alkyl groups are attached. So this is your tertiary carbocation. So this is your hydride shift happened here. After that, this chlorine will attack to this carbon atom. And there is a formation of this major product, which is your more stable product, which is formed. Now you will see this chlorine will attack to this carbon atom. And here this product is formed. And if the carbon attacks to this carbon atom, if here only the carbon attacks to this carbon atom, which is having a positive charge, which is a carbocation, then this product is your minor product. This is your minor product will be formed, and here the major product is formed. This is your major product. So that is why here two products are formed. One on the unstable carbocation and other on the stable carbocation. Again, I am telling you this reaction. This is mechanism. Here you will see the alcohol proportion OH has been substituted by this chlorine. This is not a direct substitution of the OH. Not directly the chlorine substitute this OH. So in the first step in this mechanism, you will see that in the first step there is protonation is happening, and in this you will see that this OH, this H from this chlorine here, what is happening here? Hydrolysis is happening, or you can say the dissociation, ionization is happening. This H will get the positive charge and this chlorine is getting the negative charge. This positive chlorine will attack to this oxygen atom, which is having the lone pair. That is why here you will see this O is having the then positive charge. When this O, where there after that there is a loss of this water molecule, because there is a formation of this water molecule. So this oxygen will withdraw electron from this this carbon, and this carbon will get the positive sign. And due to the hydrolysis process, so here you will see this water molecule is removed out. So this carbon is having the positive charge. So if this carbon is having the positive charge, and this is an unstable carbocation because it is a secondary carbocation, and secondary carbocation is less stable than the tertiary carbocation. So here you will see in the third step, here the hydride shift. Now the hydride shift is happening. If the chlorine attacks to this carbon atom, this carbocation, then this is an unstable, or you can say the minor product is formed. And after that, here we are. What is happening here? A hydride shift is happening. So in the hydride shift, the hydrogen withdraw electron from this carbon atom, and this carbon will get the positive charge, and it get attacked to this position, to the neighboring carbon atom. So here this is formed, and this is the stable carbocation is formed. So now this stable carbocation after that is attacked by this chlorine, and this chlorine then this attack to this stable carbocation, coordination bond will occur, and here you will see a major product, that is your stable product is formed here. This is a stable, and if the chlorine will attack to this carbocation, this will be a minor product. The two products are there, minor and your major. So secondly is your alkyl shift. So here in your alkyl shift, you will see in this alkyl shift, the reaction can undergo a different mode of rearrangement known as alkyl shift. So here there is a hydride shift. So there is a hydrogen group migrate, but in this case, in this is your alkyl shift. So in this case, the reaction can undergo a different mode of rearrangement, that is known as your alkyl shift. So here alkyl group migration will occur. So here alkyl group migration will occur. So here you will see that the reaction can undergo different mode of rearrangement, that is your alkyl shift, or you can say the alkyl group migration. Means here the alkyl group will migrate from one carbon atom to the neighboring carbon atom. So here alkyl shift act very similarly to that of hydride shift. So alkyl shift will also shift like the hydride shift. Instead of the proton that shift with the nucleophile, we see an alkyl group that shift with the nucleophile instead. So here in that hydride shift, we have seen that the proton H that shifted with the nucleophile. But here we will see that the alkyl group will shift from the with the nucleophile instead. So the shifting group carries its electron pair with it to furnish bond to the neighboring or adjacent carbon atom, carbocation. So here the shifting group, that this group that is your alkyl group, will carry the electron pair with it, and it will furnish or it will form a bond with the neighboring or the adjacent carbocation. So here you will see in the first reaction, that is your here written the living group. Here you will see there is a living group. This is your alkyl group. This is your alkyl. This is your alkyl. This is your alkyl. So here, when you are when this reactant is your reacting with this hydrogen halide, there is a removal of the water molecule, and this this product is formed. And in your primary substrate, this is your secondary substrate, and this is your primary substrate. So this is, in this case, you will see when there is when this reactant is reacting with this hydrogen halide, there is a removal of the water molecule, and this water and this halogen is then you will see a formation of this product. And in the reaction, first we see that we have a secondary substrate. Here we are having a secondary substrate, and this undergo alkyl shift because it does not have a suitable hydrogen, because here no hydrogen is present on this carbon atom. So here there is an alkyl shift will happen. So once again, the reaction similar to hydride shift. The only difference is that we shift an alkyl group rather than shift a proton, and while still undergoing various intermediate steps to furnish its final product. So here we are doing a alkyl shift instead of your hydride shift. Only the difference is this, but all the same reactions there, that there is a shifting and there is a formation of this intermediate, and after that the final product will be formed. Now in the second reaction, in the reaction second, on the other hand, we can see that it undergo a concentrated mechanism. In short, this means that everything happens in one step. This is because primary carbocation cannot be an intermediate, and they are relatively difficult process since they require high temperature and longer reaction times. After protonating the alcohol substrate to form the alkyl oxium ion, the water must leave at the same time as the alkyl group shifts from the adjacent carbon to skip the formation of the unstable primary carbocation. So here you can see that. You can see here in this mechanism of concentrated alkyl shift, this OH group is attached to this carbon atom. After that, from the alkyl halide hydrogen halide, this hydrogen, this proton is attacked by this OH. So here the water molecule is formed, and this water molecule is removed out from here. Okay, so you can see here minus H2O. Next, this is having the positive charge. After that, this alkyl group will shift from this position to this position. Okay, it will get shifted from this position, from this, because this is a primary, and this is very less stable, and this is your tertiary. And from here, when this alkyl shift is shifted from here, then this from this here from on this position, the chlorine that is dissociated from here, HCl, that will attack to this carbon atom. So here you will see this chlorine ion will attack to this position because this is more stable than this primary alkene. So here you will see this is the final product of your of this reaction. This is the final product of this reaction. Next is your ethyl alcohol. So these are the compounds that are related to the alkyl halides, and this is your ethyl chloride. Which is also known as your chloroethane or your monochloroethane. Ethyl chloride is also known as your chloroethane and monochloroethane, or it is commonly known by its old name. That is, this is your old name. This is a common name. This is your common name, and chloroethane is according to the IUPAC name. And it is a chemical compound with the chemical formula. It is having the chemical formula. This is your C2H5Cl. And once widely used in producing tetraethylene, a gasoline additive. It is used in producing this tetraethylene, and which is a gasoline additive. So here you will see the structure of this ethyl chloride. So ethyl means here two carbon atoms should be here. So here you can see the two carbon atoms are here, and chlorine should be here. So on one carbon atom, a chlorine is attached, and other and the carbon atoms are bonded to the hydrogen atom. So this is your structure of this ethyl chloride. And here you will see this the bond between the bond distance is your 0.15 nanometer, and here it is 0.178 nanometer. So this is a weak bond because here the polarity is there. Okay. And this alkyl halide, this carbon is your sp3 hybridized carbon atom, and this x is your p orbital. So here this overlapping is like this. Okay. Or here 10 angstrom is equal to your 0.1 nanometer. If you want to convert this nanometer into your angstrom, then you can do according to this. And this and its chemical formula is your C2H5Cl, that is your CH3CH2Cl. And molecular mass of this ethyl chloride is your 64.51 gram per mole. And the appearance is your colorless gas. It is a ethyl chloride, is a gas which is colorless. And its odor is pungent. Pungent smell it is having. And density is having 0.8898 gram per centimeter cube. And its melting point is -138 degree, 0.7 degree centigrade. And its boiling point is 12.27 degree centigrade. And it decomposes at the temperature of 510 degree centigrade. And here the solubility in water. So the solubility in water is 0.574 gram per 100 ml at 20 degree centigrade. So solubility in water of this ethyl chloride is this. And solubility in other solvents, in organic solvent, it is soluble in alcohol and ether. So it is soluble in alcohol and ether, but in solubility in water is it's 0.574 gram per 100 ml. And its refractive index is your 1.3676 at your 20 degree centigrade and 1.001 at your 25 degree centigrade. Next, the viscosity of is 0.279 centipoise, and dipole moment is 2.06 d. So this is your ethyl chloride structure of this ethyl chloride, its bond length, and its carbon which is attached to this alkyl halide is your sp3 hybridized, and the halide is p, and here ch2cl is the weak bond between this carbon and this chlorine, and it's also known as your chloroethane or your monochloroethane, and it is widely used in producing your tetraethylene or a gasoline additive. Next is your, it is a colorless gas also. Chloroethane is produced by hydrochlorination of ethene. So here, if this ethene is halogenated, hydrochlorinated, then there is a formation of this ethyl chloride. So chloroethane is produced by hydrochlorination of ethene. You can see here CH2H4, and we see this will add to this, and there is a formation of this gas, colorless gas. And its uses, the major use of chloroethane was to produce tetraethylene, that is your TEL. It is a petrofuel additive. It is an anti-NOC additive for gasoline. It is used as anti-NOC additive in case of gasoline. Gasoline is a gasoline or gas for short, American English, and petrol is used in British English, and which is a transparent petroleum derived liquid that is primarily as a fuel in internal combustion engine. So this is acting as a fuel in the internal combustion engine, and it is also act as a it is also produced as tetraethylene, which is also a TEL, and which is also known as, in short form it is known as TEL, and it is a petrol fuel additive, and it is an anti-NOC additive for your gasoline. So chloroethane has been used as a refrigerant and aerosol spray propellant and anesthetic and a blowing agent for foam packaging. So it is used, we can also use it as a refrigerant. It is used in the refrigerator as a gas in the for the cooling purpose. Refrigerant is used in the refrigerator for the cooling purpose. And so it is used as a cooling purpose, and it is also used as a aerosol spray propellant. So in aerosols also, it is also used this ethyl chloride, or you can say the chloroethane, and an anesthetic. It is also an anesthetic, means it is generally used as an anesthetic purpose also, and it is also a blowing agent for foam packaging. Blowing agent is also used as a blowing agent in your foam packagings. And in dentistry, chloroethane is used as one of the means of diagnosing a dead tooth, that is one in which the pulp has died. A small amount of substance is placed on the suspect tooth using a cotton wet, and the chloroethane's low boiling point creates a localizing chilling effect. If this tooth is still alive, this could be sensed by the patient as mild discomfort that subsides when the guard is removed. So here it is also used as a mean for diagnosing the death tooth in this dentistry field. And that is, that tooth here means that the in which the pulp has been died in your tooth. And in this case, what we do is that we will place a small amount of the substance, this chloroethane, on the suspect tooth using a cotton swab. So on the cotton swab, we will apply this chloroethane and then place on the tooth that we are diagnosing, suspecting it. And after that, the chloroethane, because of its low melting low boiling point, it has a chilling effect. So if the tooth is still alive, if the tooth was still alive, then this will be sensed by the patient, and it will get a little discomfort, and this will subside when the wart is removed, and this will this discomfort will be removed if the wart is removed from the tooth of the patient. And chloroethane is not classifiable as to its carcinogenicity to human, but toxic overexposure start at 9% to 12% concentrated in the heart and stop. If it is overexposed, then it is toxic to the patient, toxic to the human, and its exposure to 9 to 12% concentration, then the heart rate of the human get drops, and it is not classified as a carcinogenicity to the humans. So the uses of chloroethane was that it was widely used in that as a TEL, that is your tetraethyl lead, and it is also which is an anti-knock agent, additive for gasolines, and gasoline is a petrol or your gas that is used in the internal combustion engines. And it is also used as a refrigerant, anesthetic, aerosol spray propellant, and in your blowing agent, as in your foam packaging also. And this in the field of their dentistry, this chloroethane is also used in diagnosing the death tooth, that is your in which the pulp is dead. And here it is we apply it on the cotton swab, and then it we get then this cotton swab is applied on the tooth, and if it is alive, then if the tooth is alive, then the patient will sense some of the discomfort, and this is also not classified as a carcinogenicity to human, but it's toxic at the concentration of 9 to 12%, and due to this the heart rate is dropped in humans. Next is your chloroform. So next compound, the next organic compound is your chloroform. So the chloroform, or you can say trichloromethane, is an organic compound with your molecular formula CHCl3, and it is a colorless, sweet smelling, dense liquid that is produced on a large scale as a precursor to PTFE, which is your polytetrafluoroethylene. And it is also used as a precursor to various refrigerants. And this chloroform is having the structure that is, you're having three chlorine atom attached to this carbon atom and one hydrogen atom is attached, and it is a colorless and it is having a sweet smelling, this chloroform. And it is used for the producing this polytetrafluoroethylene, and it is also used in producing the. It is also used as a precursor to various refrigerants. And the molecule adopt tetrahedral molecular geometry, as you can see here, that it is having a tetrahedral shape. As you see here, chlorine. The angle between this chlorine, carbon and chlorine is 110 degree, and the bond angle between this chlorine and carbon and chlorine is 1.767 angstrom, and this carbon and hydrogen is having 1.073 angstrom, and the distance is having between this chlorine is having 0.7640 angstrom, and this is the Lewis structure of chloroform that is showing the electrons present on this chlorine atom and the electrons that are shared by the chlorine and the carbon atom. Next, the chemical formula of this chloroform is CHCl3, because three chlorine atoms are attached to this carbon atom and one hydrogen is attached to the carbon atom, and according to the IUPAC, its name is trichloromethane. Because three chlorine atoms are present, so its name is trichloro, and methane because one carbon atom is present, so that is why we are naming it methane. So according to the IUPAC name, its name is trichloromethane, and other name of this chloroform is methane trichloride, methyl trichloride, TCM and trichloromethane, methionyl trichloride, Peron 20 or refrigerant 20, because it is used as a precursor for the refrigerant, so its name is refrigerant 20 also. So molecular mass of this chloroform is 119.38 gram per mole, and its appearance is that it is a colorless liquid, and order is that it is ethaneal order, and the density is 1.48 gram per centimeter cube at 25 degrees centigrade. And its boiling point is 61.2 degrees centigrade. And solubility of this chloroform in water is 8.09 gram per liter at 20 degrees centigrade. And solubility in other solvents, means in organic solvent, is that it is soluble in benzene, miscible in this diethyl ether, and its shape, and its or you can say its molecular shape or its geometry, is that it is having a tetrahedral structure. Next is your chloroform volatilizes readily from soil and surface water, undergoes degradation in air to produce phosgene, dichloromethane, formyl chloride, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen chloride. Its half-life in air ranges from 55 to 620 days. The half-life of this chloroform is in air is ranges from this 55 to 620 days, and it is a volatilized. It is volatile in nature, and it can chloroform volatilizes from the soil and the surface water, and it can also undergo degradation in air, and it produces phosgene and dichloromethane, formyl chloride, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen chloride. So here you can see the chloroform on oxidation here form this COCl2 and 2HCl, and this is which is your phosgene. COCl2 is your phosgene, and you can see here between the carbon and the oxygen, the bond length is your 118 pm, and carbon chlorine is 174 pm, and here you can see the bond angle between this chlorine, carbon, and chlorine is 111.8 degree. So this is a phosgene, and in industrial, chlorine is produced by heating a mixture of chlorine and either chloromethane or methane at 400 degree to 500 degree centigrade, and a radical free radical halogenation occurs. This is a process of free radical halogenation in which the chloroform is produced and converting this precursor to progressively more chlorinated compound. As you can see, this methane when is chlorinated, then it forms this chloromethane and HCl, and then again this chloromethane when is chlorinated, then it forms dichloromethane. After that, this dichloromethane when is again chlorinated, then it forms the chloroform. And by after this chloroform is formed, the chloroform is then chlorinated, then it forms the carbon tetrachloride is formed. Next is your uses of this chloroform. So the hydrogen attached to this carbon in chloroform participate in the hydrogen bonding, and worldwide, globally, this chloroform is also used in pesticide formulation. So this chloroform is also used in pesticide formulation and as a solvent for fats, oils, rubber, waxes, gutta percha, and resins. As a cleansing agent also it is used, and a grain fumigant in fire extinguishers, and in the rubber industry also it is used. So chloroform is also used to extract and purify penicillin. Chloroform used for the extraction and purification of alkaloids. Chloroform was properly as an anesthetic from the mid 1800 to around 1900, but it was found to cause death from paralysis. So here it was used as an anesthetic in the mid 1800 to 1900, but it was found that it causes death, which is due to the paralysis. And it also depresses the most of the other organs like your blood vessels, liver, pancreas, and kidneys. And it is toxic to the liver also. So oxygen gas mixtures regained use in anesthesia also after 1900, and chloroform was replaced by safer compound after about 1940. So here chloroform gives relieve the pain of childbirth. Chloroform also relieves the pain that that is due to the childbirth. And although chloroform did carry some risk of heart failure also, it was very more pleasant to take or more powerful than ether. It is more pleasant to take, but it is more powerful than your ether. In Victorian anesthetic and inhaler to regulate the amount of chloroform administered to a patient so that patient felt no pain but remained conscious. Now the third organic compound is your trichloroethylene. So the chemical compound trichloroethylene is a halocarbon commonly used as an industrial solvent. It is a clear, non-flammable liquid with a sweet smell. And the trichloroethylene is not a persistent chemical in the atmosphere, and its half-life is in air is about 7 days. And the chemical formula of this trichloroethylene is your C2HCl3. And the IUPAC name is trichloroethene, and the other name of this trichloroethylene is 112-trichloroethene, 112-dichloro-2-chloroethylene, acetylene, 1-chloro-2-2-dichloroethylene. Molar mass is 131.4 gram per mole. Appearance is your colorless liquid. Order is your color chloroform-like. Density is your 1.46 gram per centimeter cube. Boiling point is 87.2 degrees centigrade. Solubility in water is 1.28 gram per liter. And solubility is in other solvent is that soluble in benzene, ether, ethanol, and chloroform. Next is the structure of this trichloroethylene. And when 1,2-dichloro is heated to around 400 degrees centigrade, it is converted to your trichloroethylene. And its uses is that the bond angles are given. And here the uses is that the main use of trichloroethylene is vapor degreasing of metal parts. So here it is used as a vapor degreasing of metal parts, and it is also used in the extraction solvent for grease, oil, fats, waxes, and tars, a chemical intermediate in the production of other chemical, and is also used as a refrigerant. It is also used as a consumer product such as the typewriter correction fluid and paint removers, strippers, adhesives, spot removers, and a rug cleaning fluid also. And this trichloroethylene was also used in the past as a general anesthetic. And its acute effect is that the central nervous system effects are the primary effect noted from the acute inhalation exposure to this trichloroethylene in human system inducing. If we inhale it, this trichloroethylene, then these primary effects were noted, and the symptoms for that is it causes sleepiness, fatigue, a headache, confusion, feeling of euphoria, effects on the liver, kidney, gastrointestinal system, and skin also has been noted. And new data suggests that trichloroethylene is a likely human carcinogen. So it is a carcinogen also to the human. Now the fourth is your dichloromethane. So the dichloromethane is also known as DCM or methylene chloride, is an organic compound with the formula CH2Cl2. It is a colorless volatile liquid and which is moderately sweet and is widely used as a solvent and is not miscible in water, but it is miscible with many organic solvents. And its natural source of this dichloromethane is that it is it can be obtained from this oceanic sources like macroalgae, wetlands, volcanoes. However, the majority of dichloromethane in the environment is the result of industrial emission. Due to this industrial emission, this dichloromethane is present in the environment. Macroalgae are the sweet weed, refers to the several species of macroscopic multicellular marine algae. So macroalgae are the marine algae, and the DCM is also produced by treating the chloromethane or the methane with the chlorine gas at 400 to 500 degrees centigrade. Next, this is the chemical formula of CH2Cl2, and the allopic name is dichloromethane. Another name is methylene chloride, methylene dichloride, and the molecular mass is 84.97 gram per mole. Appearance is colorless liquid. Its order is like chloroform. Density is this. Boiling point is 39.6 degrees centigrade. Solubility is in this water, and the solubility in other organic solvent is that it is miscible in ethyl acetate, alcohol, hexane, benzene, carbon tetrachloride, diethyl ether, chloroform. And it is having this molecular structure of these and comparing the carbon chlorine bond length. Next is your uses. So this is the 3D structure. This is the Lewis structure of this, and the bond angle is 109.5 degree. And it is used DCM volatility and ability to dissolve a wide range of organic compounds. And it is useful as a solvent and many chemical processes also. And it is widely used as a degreaser and the paint strippers. And in the food industry, it is used as decaffeinated coffee and tea, as well as to prepare extracts of herbs and other flavoring. Its volatility is that it is used in the aerosol spray propellant and a blowing agent from polyurethane foams. Next is your tetrachloromethane. So tetrachloromethane is also known as carbon tetrachloride, and it is also used as a fire extinguisher, as a precursor to refrigerant, as a cleaning agent, and it is a colorless liquid and with a sweet smell that can be detected at low level, and it has practically no flammability at lower temperature. So this is your carbon tetrachloride, which is and the Lewis structure of this carbon tetrachloride is like this. And next, why is carbon tetrachloride molecule non-polar and yet the bonds in it are polar? So this is a non-polar, but the bonds in this are polar because of the molecular geometry. In this, the order of the molecule to be polar, and it must have a net dipole moment. In this case, the carbon tetrachloride, the net dipole moment is it's zero. So this CCl bond is quite polar, and chlorine is more electronegative than carbon, which means that it will attract the bonding electron more, and the partial negative charge will appear on the chlorine atom and partially positive charge will appear on the carbon atom, and a dipole moment will thus appear for each of the four carbon chloride bond that exist in a molecule of carbon tetrachloride. And the carbon tetrachloride has a tetrahedral molecular geometry. This means that the resultant of any 3CCl bond will always be equal in magnitude and have an opposite direction. So in other words, that no net dipole moment will exist, and because the four bond dipole moment that arises from the polar CCl bond will cancel each other out. So the molecular formula is CCl4, its allopic name is carbon tetrachloride tetrachloromethane, and the geometry, oligomolecular shape is tetrahedral, and its other name is carbon chloride, methane tetrachloride, methyl tetra Chloride per chloromethane. Its appearance is colorless liquid. Its odor is ether-like. Its boiling point is 76.7 degrees centigrade. Its solubility in water is 0.097 gram per mole liter. And its solubility in other solvent in organic solvent is alcohol, ether, chloroform, benzene, naphtha, PS2, formic acid. So it is mainly produced from methane by the chlorination, and this is methane when it's reacted with this 4 mole of chlorine, then carbon tetrachloride is formed. And the uses it is used to produce the chlorofluorocarbon refrigerant and R11 and the R12. And it is also used in the detection of neutrino. And it is also used in the determination of oil that is replaced by the other solvent, that is your tetrachloroethylene. And because it is having no CH bond, so it does not undergo free radical reactions. And it is also used as a solvent in the halogenation. It is used as a dry cleaning solvent and a refrigerant and in lava lamp also. And carbon tetrachloride is also used as a potent hepatotoxin that is toxic to the liver. And it is also, the scientific research also evaluate that it is hepatoprotective agent. And at under high temperature, it forms poisonous porcine gas. And the last organic compound is your iodoform. It is an organoiodic compound with the molecular formula PHI3. It is a pale yellow crystalline volatile substance. And it is having a penetrating and distinctive odor. And it is also used as a disinfectant. And it is also known as your triiodomethane, carbon triiodoiodide, and methyl triiodo. And its iopec name is triiodomethane. Other name is iodoform. Appearance is like pale yellow, light yellow opaque crystals. And its odor is saffron-like. And its melting point is 119 degrees centigrade. And solubility in water is 100 mg per liter. And it is miscible in diethyl ether, acetone, and ethanone. It can be produced by the halogenation of methyl ketone. Here you can see the ketone is reacted with this halogen and there is a formation of this iodoform. Next, the uses are in small scale. It is used as a disinfectant. In medicines, it is used as healing and antiseptic dressing for wounds and sores. And it is also used as an active ingredient in your ear powder for cats and dogs, along with zinc oxide and propionic acid, which are used to prevent infection and facilitate the removal of ear hair. Next, it is also used as a disinfectant, wooden scores, and it is also used in sterilizing instruments that are used in surgery. And it is also has many side effects with this iodoform, but it is therefore its use has now been suppressed because new antiseptics are discovered, and it is also used in cat and dog powders. Halogens and the character of the carbon halogen bond. So here its halogens are more electronegative than carbons, and this result in a carbon halogen bond that is polarized as shown in the image below. And the carbon bond atom has a partial positive charge while the hydrogen halogen is having a partial negative charge. So the polarity of the CX bond you can see here. The relationship between the halogen and electronegativity is that according to the periodic table, the iodine to the fluorine, electronegativity increases. So fluorine is more electronegative than the other halogens. So the relationship between the bond length, you can see the bond length, bond strength, and the molecular size. It decreases and the strength of the bond decreases, and as the bond get longer and the molecular size also increases. And the influence of the bond polarity on of the four halogen, fluorine is the most electronegative and iodine the least. So the electronegative of carbon and iodines are equal. So there is no separation of charge on the bond. So now last the questions. The name of the compound is? Answer A. That is your trichloroethylene. The name of this compound is? Tetrachloromethane, which is used as disinfectant for iodoform. Which one of the following molecule does not form alcohol when react with Grignard reagent? That is your carbon dioxide. The ether that is used in wood synthesis is your dry. When alkyl halide undergo reduction, there will be a formation of this alkane, which is a component of the lava lamp. That is your tetrachloromethane, which is the Grignard reagent, that is your alkaline magnesium halide, which is not used as refrigerant, that is your iodoform, and which compound forms poisonous phosgene, that is your carbon tetrachloride. So these are the references from where you can study this topic. And thank you so much for today's lecture.